Good morning, class 8. Guess you all are doing good, fine, rocking and taking care of yourselves at home and being safe and being happy, studying, eating, sleeping, playing and being with your family. That's the best thing ever could happen now, and please be safe and take care of yourselves because the virus is spreading quite effectively and very fast. So we have to just make sure that we are all safe and sound and at home. Unless and until it's very necessary, no need to go out because you are children, you don't have to go out. Your parents also need to be very cautious while they are going out and coming back so that no one gets infected with this bad virus, you know, it's not good. So we are coming to the first part of the Green Grass Running Water, a bear, a fiction. It's a story of fiction written by Luther Standing Bear himself. Now Luther Standing Bear, 1868 to 1939, was an Oglala Lakota chief, a native North American tribe. Okay. And the first son of George Standing Bear and Pretty Face. These are all people's names. The tribes, the people in the tribes have the different kind of names from animals. A Lakota leader of his generation and a traditional hunter and warrior. Standing Bear was also a famous Native American author, philosopher and actor of the 20th century. Standing Bear fought to preserve Lakota heritage and sovereignty and actively took part in a progress movement to change the government policy towards the Native Americans. In his book titled The Stories of the Sioux, Sioux are Native American Indians, you know, that's the tribe. Standing Bear narrates legends that he had heard in his youth. He has 4 books and several articles to his credit. Luther Standing Bear himself is Standing Bear. His name, Luther Standing Bear, he himself is the name, and he is writing, he is one of the tribe people. The government was very bad on the Native Americans. They were the actual Americans, the tribes, and what happened with them and what went on. And he narrates the progressive movement they had, you know, revolution type of thing, to change the government policy towards the Native Americans. So we are going to read about that. Let's see what happens, how far we understand and how far I can explain it to you. Okay, so let's begin. Page 36, Unit 2, My English Folder Course Book, page 38, A Bear, Section 1. A Bear is fiction. Okay. And then what is in section 2, I want to just see before I start the section 1. What is there I want to see? Okay, fine, that's another story by Ruskin Bond. Native legends had a lot to do with nature and the wild because the lives of the people were closely linked with them. Eco-balancing was there. People who live in the jungle have to have a relationship with the animals and the trees and that life section. Atmosphere is different, climate is different, source of living is different. While native legends were retold to popularize local culture and practices, they also narrated tales of courage, kindness and humanity that were closely linked with nature. The stories of Sioux, as I said, they are a tribe of the Native American of North America, is one such book that was written as a part of an effort to popularize the Lakota culture, particularly at a time when the Native Americans had to face the brunt of reservations and oppressive government policies. what is brunt of reservations a part in the society, you know, that ST SC reservations we have, like that a tribal reservation in their government policies, oppressive, they were being oppressed by the government, they were not getting their actual rights. The book is a collection of stories about the buffalo, the dog, the horse, the eagle and the wolf, and also about the heroism and resourcefulness of individual men and women during this revolution or during this change or whatever was happening for their rights. One such story about grandmother is presented to you in this section. So we'll only read about one character, that is grandmother. So generally this is all about a native tribe in the north of America, how they used to go ahead, why they are called bears, because they had a relationship with the animals also. They tried to take animal names to prove themselves that we act like that animal. You know, if you are called a tiger, that means you are like a tiger. So if you are a bear, so you act like a bear, that's why your name is bear. It was August. The wild turnips were growing on the hillsides and the choke cherries. Small little cherries, you know, like red color, or they can be of blue colors. Sometimes it's green when it's raw. So these are bitter, they are not sweet when they are. When these choke cherries were actually ripe in the thickets along the river, they grow along the rivers in the like bushes and all along the river, shrubs type, and they are grow together a lot, so that's why they are called thickets. It's like a bush. Turnips, you know, it grows under the ground. So grandmother was then a young woman. Now Luther Standing Bear is talking about his grandmother during that time. One day she and some girls of the village gathered a number of children and went all up the hillside to dig for wild turnips, jungly desi turnips, of which the Sioux were very fond. That tribe was very fond of these jungly turnips and they used to cook it for dinner. The girls carried long sharp sticks to pry. Pry means to what you say, can I give it in another word, is you use sticks to walk, you know, it's a tough way, so you take sticks to walk, to take care of yourself, to defend yourself, you know, so that's why sticks are taken. So it's a tough trail to obtain something with great difficulty or task, you know, you have to go and dig, so that stick is going to come in, that's, it's a tough job. That's why they had sticks with them. The girls carried long sharp sticks to pry, to the difficulty which they are going to face, they took the sticks. Pry the turnips from the ground, so dig out the turnips, quite difficult. Grandmother, however, carried an iron rod. For in her day, white people were among the Sioux and had brought iron things that the Indians have never owned. The Americans used to kill them, shoot them, take them as laborers, kidnap them, the white people. So iron means gun, but she had only a rod. She also thought they have also got iron things with them which we haven't owned yet, we don't have one. So she had taken a rod in case someone attacks them. When a bunch of four or five turnips had been gathered, the long white roots were braided together in order so that they could be more easily carried while others were being gathered. Braided means when you tie your hair, isn't it? So the roots are put into one each other into knots and they hang them on the shoulder or you hang it on a stick, and so that they could be more easily carried, and at the same time digging was also going on for more turnips. When they were taken home, they were hung into the sun to dry, then put away in raw hide bags. Rawhide is actually skin of animals. Rawhide, which is not tanned or it's not put into salt or it's not taken care of. I'll come back in the next video and I'll explain this. Okay.